Hello and welcome back, dear students. Wish you all stay happy, healthy and safe at home and do your studies regularly and properly. I'm Yojana Parakh and today we are going to start a new chapter from your English grammar. The name of this chapter is Word Power. Let us see this chapter. The first topic we are going to see is compound words. What are compound words? When after joining two or more words which have different spelling, different meaning, a new word is framed with new meaning, that is called compound word. Compound word is a word made up of two or more words. The meaning of a compound word is different from the meaning of the words that make it up. Those words which we have joined, the meaning of those words will be different and the meaning of the compound word will be different. Now let us see some examples. Here, foot, that is our body part. Next is ball. By joining both these words, new word will be formed. Football. Football is a game also and it is a type of ball which is used in that particular game. So here this is body part and this is the thing, but by joining these two words, a new word is framed, that is game, that is name of a game, and in that game the particular ball, the particular thing is used, its name of that thing. So by joining these two different words which have different meaning, a new word has been formed with new meaning. Next is basket and ball. So we know basket, which we use for carrying things, for our daily use things, and ball, that is a thing. And by joining basket and ball, new word is formed, basketball, which again is the name of a game, and in that game a particular kind of ball is used, that is called basketball. So basket is made up of crisscross net, and ball is the thing which we use for play. By joining these two different words with different meaning, a new word has been formed, that is called compound word. And the meaning of this new word is different from both the words which have been joined for making this word. Next is water plus melon. Water, you can say that is the liquid which we use for drinking and cleaning and other so many purpose. And melon, that is a fruit. By joining water melon, a new word is formed, watermelon, that is another type of food, fruit. So in this way, by joining two different words with two different meaning, a new word has been formed with new meaning, that is called compound word. Next word is finger, that is our body part, and print, that means the impression, chap. By joining both this word, new word has been formed, fingerprint, the impression of our fingers. So in this way, this word is different, having different meaning, having different spelling. And this word is also different, having different meaning, different spelling. By joining these two words, we can see the spelling is same as both these words, but a new word has been formed, that is called compound word, with new meaning. The meaning of this word is not same as both these words. So in this way, by joining two or more words, a new word is formed, that is called compound word, and the meaning of this new word will be different from the words which have been used to make this word. You will get it more clearly by this exercise. So let us see the exercise of this chapter. Match this word on the left with the word on the right to form compound words. One has been done for you. Book. Match the book with shop. Book, that means kitab, and shop, that is dukan. Both are different words having different meaning. By joining both these words, new word will be formed. Bookshop, that means a particular shop made for books. Next is door. Door can be paired with no. So door, that means gate, darwaza, and no, that is the lock on the door. So by joining door and no, that means darwaza or lock, by joining these two word, new word will be formed, that is door knob, the knob which is placed on the door. Next is up, and we can pair up with steps. So new word will be formed, upstairs, that means upar ki taraf. Stairs, that means seedhi, and up, that is the direction, upward direction. And by joining both these word, new word will be formed, upstairs, that is in upward direction, the stair which go in upward direction. Next word is fire. We can pair fire with man. Man, that is human, fire, that is aag. And if we pair fire with man, new word will be formed, fireman, that is the person who extinguished the fire. Next word is flower. We can pair flower with pot. New word will be formed, flower pot. Flower, that is full, pot, that is the thing made of clay. If we pair flower with pot, new word will be formed, flower pot, that means the vase which is kept for keeping flowers. Next is waist. Waist is our body part, and COAT, coat. Coat is the type of cloth we wear. By pairing both this word, new word will be formed, waistcoat. That is an upper garment. With this, our topic of compound words has come to an end. The new topic we are going to see is homophones. What are homophones? Homophones are those words which sound similar but are having different spelling and different meaning. In compound word, we saw that spelling was same as the words which have been combined to form that new word, but the meaning and pronunciation was different. Here the pronunciation is same, but the meaning and spelling is different. So those words which have the same pronunciation, the same sound, which are pronounced similarly but have different meaning and different spelling, those words are called homophones. Here some examples are given. Air hair, fair fair, hole hole, male male, piece piece, stare stare. Both are pronounced similarly, both have same sound but have different spelling and different meaning. I tell you the meaning of these words. Air, that is wind, and hair, that is the dissenter of human. Next is fair. Fair, that means light complexion, fair complexion, color. Or FARE, fair, that means the rent paid for traveling or for staying somewhere. Next is hole. Hole, that is the hole made in something, the blank space, that is called hole, chain. Whole, that is completely, M-A-I-L, male. Here you can see the image of male letters, and male is the man, or you can say masculine gender. Peace, P-E-A-C-E, peace, that means calmness, shanti. P-I-E-C-E, peace, that means tukda, a fraction of something. S-T-A-I-R, stare, stare, that is seedhi. And S-T-A-R-E, stare, that means to look steadily at something, ghurna. So in this way, all these words were pronounced similarly but were having different spelling and different meaning. So these words are known as homophones because they sound similarly but have different spelling and different meaning. Let us see the exercise on this topic. Fill in the blanks with the correct words from the brackets. One has been done for you. Dash class do you study in? So here two spellings are given. W-I-T-C-H, which, and W-H-I-C-H, which. Which, that is the female dog. So here the question is asked, that means the question word should be used. That is W-H-I-C-H. So which is the correct option that we have to write in that blank. Which class do you study in? Next is the dash of the sun illuminated the room. R-A-Y-S, rays, that is the light of sun. And R-A-I-S is rays, that means to appreciate. So here the sun have light, that means rays. So the correct option will be R-A-Y-S, rays, that we have to write here. The rays of the sun illuminated, lighten the room, brighten the room. The mountain dash was covered with snow. P-E-A-K, peak, and P-E-E-K, peak. Here P-E-A-K, peak, that means the highest point of mountain, and P-E-E-K, peak, that means to look secretly. So here for mountain the correct word will be P-E-A-K, peak, that is the highest point of the mountain. So the sentence will be, the mountain peak was covered with snow. The highest point of the mountain was covered with snow. Next is, we shall have to dash a driver soon. H-I-R-E, hire, that means to keep someone on the job. And H-I-G-H-E-R, hire, that means an increased degree. So here they are hiring the driver, that means they are giving job to a person. So here the correct option will be H-I-R-E, hire. Kaam par rakhna. Next is, father came back home late last. N-I-G-H-T, night, or K-N-I-G-H-T, night. So N-I-G-H-T, night is the time duration of the day, is the period of the day. Night, that means rat. K-N-I-G-H-T, night, that refers to the horse. So here, as the time is considered, we will write N-I-G-H-T, night. Father came back home late last night. Next is, the dash arrived earlier than expected. Who will arrive? Guest or guest? Guest is the person, mehman, who will come. And guest, that means to think, to get the idea. So idea won't arrive. People will arrive that are called guest. So here those are called guests. So here we will write, the guest arrived earlier than expected. So here the correct option will be G-U-E-S-T, guest. So in this way, the exercise of homophones also come to an end.